Dear friends, today we are discussing the chapter Theory of Consumer Behavior from Microeconomics. Here we are discussing how an individual consumer behaves in the market. In our day-to-day life, we know we want to purchase different combinations of goods with our limited income. The economists call this as problem of choice. The consumer wants to purchase those combinations which give maximum satisfaction to the consumer. Here, the combination that depends upon the likes of the consumer. Likes also known as preference. The best combination that depends upon the preference of the consumer and the effort to buy. Here, effort to buy that depends upon income of the consumer and the price of the commodity. Here, we are discussing the behavior of an individual consumer, and mainly here we are discussing two approaches. That is, first one, cardinal utility approach by Alfred Marshall, and the second one, ordinal utility approach by J.R. Hicks. Then we want to discuss the concept utility. Before discussing the concept utility, we want to understand some assumptions and basic concepts. Here we are assuming that the consumer is purchasing only two goods. In our day-to-day life, we know a consumer is purchasing large number of goods and services, but for simplicity, here we are assuming that the consumer is purchasing only two goods. Then we want to understand the concept consumer bundle. Then what is consumer bundle? The combinations of two goods a consumer can purchase at the given level of income or amount of two goods a consumer can buy. That is known as consumer bundle. If the first commodity, that is X1, and the second commodity is X2, then consumer bundle is X1, X2. For example, we can take two goods, bananas and oranges. If one consumer is purchasing 3 units of bananas and 5 units of oranges, then consumer bundle is 3, 5. Then we can discuss the concept utility. When we are hungry, we want food. When we are thirsty, we want water. Then, these both goods, food and water, they are satisfying our want. So, they have utility. Then what is utility? Wants satisfying power of a commodity. That is known as utility. Wants satisfying power of a commodity. That is known as utility. Utility is subjective in nature. Why? Different individuals will get different levels of satisfaction from the same commodity. Those who like oranges, they will get more satisfaction from it. And if an individual doesn't like orange, he will get only less satisfaction or utility from orange. Then a consumer, he is deriving his demand for a commodity from the utility from that commodity. If one individual, if he gets more utility from a commodity, he will purchase more and demand for that commodity will increase. Then we want to discuss cardinal utility. What is cardinal utility? We can measure utility by using cardinal numbers like 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. For example, we can measure the utility of a banana as 5 or utility of an orange is 10. Like that, we can measure the utility of commodities in terms of numbers. That approach is known as cardinal utility approach. What is utility? We know wants satisfying power of a commodity. That is known as utility. Then we want to know what is total utility. Then what is total utility? The total satisfaction derived from a given amount of goods. That good may be good X. We can explain this with the help of this term. Here we are representing units of commodities in the first column and total utility in the second column. First, in the first column we can see commodity X or bananas. For example, we are taking here bananas. From the first unit of banana, a consumer will get 12 utils of utility. That is total utility here. The total satisfaction or utility derived from the given level of a commodity. What is the commodity here? Banana. What is the given level? 1 unit. From 1 unit, the consumer will get 12 utils of utility. That utility or satisfaction is known as total utility. We can take second unit, or we can take 2 units of banana or 2 bananas. From this 2 units, the consumer will get 18 utils of utility. That 18 units of utility is known as total utility here. Why? We know what is total utility? The utility derived from the given amount of a commodity. Here commodity is banana. Then what is the given level? 2 bananas. From 2 bananas, he will get 18 units of utility. Total utility or total satisfaction derived from this 2 units of banana, that is 18. So here total utility is 18. Then we want to discuss here marginal utility. Then what is marginal utility? The addition to total utility while consuming one more unit of a commodity. Addition to total utility while consuming one more unit of a commodity. Here also we can use this table. First column, we are representing first commodity, that is bananas. Second column, we are representing total utility. And the third column, we are representing marginal utility. Okay, we know from first banana, we will get 12 utils of utility. Then we can take second banana. Or we can take 2 units of bananas. At that time, When consumer is using 2 units of bananas, he will get 18 units of or 18 utils of utility. Then what is the addition to total utility when he is using one more unit of banana? Utility increasing from 12 to 18. Then what is addition there? Change from 12 to 18, that is 6. That 6 is known as marginal utility. Then what is marginal utility? Addition to total utility while consuming one more unit of a commodity. Then what is addition here in total utility? From 12 to 18, that is 6 utils are the addition here while using one more unit of banana. Okay, so addition is 6, that is known as marginal utility. We can use second example. When consumer is using 3 units of banana or 3 bananas, at that time total utility increasing from 18 to 22. Then what is addition here? Total utility increasing from 18 to 22. That means addition is 4 here. That 4 is known as marginal utility. Then when consumer is using one more unit of banana, from 2 units to 3 units, at that time total utility increasing from 18 to 22. Then what is addition here? 4. That 4 is known as marginal utility. Then we want to discuss law of diminishing marginal utility. Before discussing law of diminishing marginal utility, first we can check this table. In this table we can see when consumer is using the commodity is banana here. When consumer is using more and more units of bananas, the marginal utility of bananas decreasing. When he is using first banana, his marginal utility is 12. And when he is using his second banana, marginal utility is 6. When he is using third banana, marginal utility is 4. Like that, marginal utility is decreasing. When he is using fifth unit, marginal utility is 0. When he is using one more unit, that is sixth unit, marginal utility will become negative. This law is known as law of diminishing marginal utility. Then how can we state that? Law of diminishing marginal utility states that when a consumer is using more and more units of a particular commodity, the marginal utility derived from that commodity will diminish or decrease. That law is known as law of diminishing marginal utility. We can explain this with the help of a diagram. In this diagram, we are representing commodity on the x-axis and total utility, marginal utility on the y-axis. Here we can see when the consumer is using one unit of banana, at that time marginal utility is high. When he is using more and more units of bananas, marginal utility decreasing. When he is using 50 unit of banana, marginal utility is 0. When he is using 6th one, marginal utility is negative. Here we can see total utility curve also. Here total utility increasing but at a diminishing rate. increasing, but that slope is not that much steep. It is declining or diminishing. Then we can see here the relationship between total utility and marginal utility. When total utility is increasing at a diminishing rate, marginal utility is decreasing. First relation, when total utility is increasing at a diminishing rate, marginal utility decreasing. When total utility is maximum, marginal utility is zero. When total utility is decreasing, marginal utility will be negative. These are the three relationship between total utility and marginal utility. Then here I am giving you some words. First, you want to prepare one schedule representing total utility and marginal utility. And on that basis, you want to draw one diagram which represents total utility and marginal utility. And find out the relationship between total utility and marginal utility.